Hello everyone, welcome to the NGR. Today we are going to do 30th June current affairs. These have been compiled by me, Bhavna, from different important news sources such as the Indian Express, the Hindu, PIB and all the other important news sources. Now this is an overview of today's session. So we are going to start with the national news, which would be followed by the state's news, important international news. Then it will be followed by economy, business and banking news. Then we'll be covering the important reports and index. Then it will come to people in news. And in the last, we are going to do important days and events. Let's start with the important national news. So the first important national news is Nasha Mukt Bharat, which is an annual action plan for 2020 to 2021, has been launched by Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment on the occasion of International Day Against Drug Abuse and Illicit Trafficking. This day falls on 26th June. So this action plan has been released for the 272 most affected districts. Now, Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment is the nodal ministry for drug demand reduction, which coordinates and monitors all aspects of drug abuse prevention, which include assessment of the extent of problem, preventive action, treatment, rehabilitation of addicts, and dissemination of information and public awareness. So this scheme was e-launched, that means it was launched virtually by Sri Ratan Lal Kataria, who is the Minister of State for Social Justice and Empowerment. The Union Minister of Social Justice and Empowerment is Mr. Thawarchand Gehlot. The Nasha Mukt Bharat Annual Action Plan would focus on 272 most affected districts and launch a three-pronged attack combining efforts of Narcotics Bureau, outreach or awareness by social justice and treatment through health department. So the action plan has following components: awareness generation programs, focus on higher educational institutions, university campuses and schools, community outreach and identification of dependent population, focus on treatment facilities in hospital settings and capacity building programs for service provider. The important questions from this news would be, who among the following has launched the Nasha Mukt Bharat Action Plan? Which of the following ministries has launched the Nasha Mukt Bharat Annual Action Plan? How many districts would be the focus of the Nasha Mukt Bharat Annual Plan for 2020 to 2021? And how many departments or ministries are involved in the strategy of Nasha Mukt Bharat Annual Action Plan? So talking about the Narcotic Bureau, so Narcotics Bureau is actually the nodal drug law enforcement and intelligence agency of India. It is responsible for fighting drug trafficking and the abuse of illegal substances. It is headquartered in New Delhi and the director general is Rakesh Asthana. So we just had one national news today. We are going to cover the important states related news now. So the first news in this section is that Apollo Tyres would commission their manufacturing plant in Andhra Pradesh. So Apollo Tyres have decided to commission its manufacturing plant in Chittoor district of Andhra Pradesh, and it is going to invest around ₹3,800 crores in building phase one of the factory. This is going to be the fifth manufacturing capacity of the company in India and seventh in the world. So how would this be helpful? So first of all, it would generate employment. Secondly, it would help to target premium original equipment manufacturers and aftermarket consumers in India. The important questions from this news would be, which of the following has decided to invest ₹38 crores in phase one in building a factory in Andhra Pradesh? Second important question would be, where has Apollo Tyres Limited announced commissioning of its manufacturing plant? So the answer would be Chittoor district of Andhra Pradesh. So moving on to the next news, Madhya Pradesh is going to launch Kill Corona campaign from July 1 to screen the entire population. So Madhya Pradesh government is going to launch this campaign in which it would screen entire population of the state in a fortnight. This campaign would start from Bhopal and will cover each family. Teams are being formed in this regard. COVID Mitra will also be made, who will voluntarily work for this campaign. So all these important campaigns and schemes which have been launched by state governments are very, very important from the perspective of paper. And the important question from this news would be, which of the following states has launched Kill Corona campaign, or what is the name of the campaign that Madhya Pradesh has launched to screen its entire population? The next news is Chhattisgarh has launched Godhan Nyay Yojana. with this, it has become the first Indian state to buy cow dung from cattle owners. So Chhattisgarh CM Bhupesh Baghel has launched this Godhan Nyay Yojana, under which government is going to procure cow dung from livestock owners, which is the cattle owners, at a fixed procurement rate. So this scheme aims to make animal husbandry commercially profitable, prevent open grazing by cattle, and solve the problem of stray animals on roads and for environment conservation. It is also expected to boost the efforts made by state government to strengthen the rural economy. Again, the important questions, and so the scheme is very important. So direct question can be asked in paper. Which state has launched the Godhan Nyay Yojana, or which of the following is the first Indian state to buy cow dung from cattle owners, or Godhan Nyay Yojana is related to which of the following, or which of the following is the scheme launched by Chhattisgarh under which it will buy cow dung from the cattle owners. Now let's have a look at the important international news. The first important news is Russia has kicked off a referendum for bringing about constitutional changes which would help to keep the president Vladimir Putin in power until 2036. So this Russia has kicked off early voting in a national referendum on some controversial amendments to the country's constitution that could allow President Vladimir Putin to stay in power until 2036. This vote had already been delayed amid the coronavirus pandemic. So the constitutional changes unveiled, these were unveiled early this year, will formally seal Putin's long-term hold on the presidency. Putin has been in power for 2 decades, and under current law, he must step down after his term expires in 2024. So the important question from this news would be, which country has kicked off a referendum for bringing about constitutional changes to keep its president in power until 2036? The second important question could be, under the current law of Russia, till when would be Vladimir Putin the president of the country? The third question could be, under the referendum for constitutional changes, Vladimir Putin would be in power until which of the following years? So, in important news, China is going to construct Kohola Hydroelectric Power Plant in POK under the China-Pakistan Economic Corridor, which is also referred as CPEC. So, CPEC is a collection of infrastructure projects that are under construction throughout Pakistan since 2013. And these construction projects are being carried out by China. So, Kohola Hydroelectric Power Plant is also a step in that direction only. It is a 1124 megawatt hydroelectric power plant, which would be situated on Jhelum River, and it will be located near the villages of Siran and Barsala in Muzaffarabad district of Pakistan-occupied Kashmir. This project aims at annually providing more than 5 billion units of clean and low-cost electricity for consumers in Pakistan. So a tripartite agreement has been finalized for the same. So the important questions from this news would be, which of the following countries is going to construct Kohola Hydroelectric Power Plant? So Kohola Hydroelectric Power Plant is situated in which of the following countries? Kohola Hydroelectric Power Plant is situated on which of the following rivers? The next news is that World Bank has approved $500 million to help Bangladesh to improve road connectivity along the Jaisalmer-Jhendia corridor covering 4 western districts. So the Western Economic Corridor and Regional Enhancement, which is WECEAR, Phase 1 project is the first of a multi-phase $1.4 billion World Bank program to upgrade the existing 110-kilometer two-lane highway Ghomra, Satkira, Navaron and Jahor Jhendia to a safer, climate-resilient 4-lane highway in Western Bangladesh. It will support the government's plan of developing a 260-kilometer economic corridor in the western part and benefit over 20 million people. So direct question from this would be, which of the following countries has received $500 million aid from the World Bank for the developing cross-country road projects? And WECEAR is a project related to which of the following countries? So talking about World Bank, so World Bank is an international financial institution that provides loans and grants to the governments of poor countries for the purpose of pursuing capital projects. It is headquartered in Washington, D.C. and the president is David Malpass, and Anshula Kant is the managing director and chief financial officer of the World Bank. Now we'll be covering the important economy, banking, and business related news. World Bank has approved $500 million for STARS in India. Now, what is STARS? STARS is Strengthening Teaching, Learning, and Results for States programs. So the World Bank's Board of Executive Director has approved a loan of $500 million, which is approximately 3,700 crores, to improve the quality and governance of school education in 6 Indian states. And these states are Himachal Pradesh, Kerala, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Odisha, and Rajasthan. STARS aim to improve learning assessment systems, strengthen classroom instruction and remediation, facilitate school-to-work transition, and strengthen governance and decentralized management. So the important questions from this news would be, World Bank has approved $500 million loans for which program in India? Expand STARS, or what does S stand for, or T stands for in STARS? And which of the following Indian states is not included in the $500 million loan approved by the World Bank? And how many Indian states would be covered under the loan provided by the World Bank for the STARS program? The next news is SIDBI has set up Swavalamban Crisis Responsive Fund for MSMEs. Now let's go one by one. First of all, what is the full form of SIDBI? SIDBI is the Small Industries Development Bank of India. It is headquartered in Lucknow, Uttar Pradesh, and the chairman and managing director is Mohammad Mustafa. So it has set up Swavalamban Crisis Responsive Funds to support free onboarding for MSMEs. Now, what are MSMEs? MSMEs are micro, small, and medium enterprises on the TREDS. Now, what is TREDS? TREDS is the Trade Receivables Discounting System. So the free onboarding of MSMEs would be available till September end. So TREDS is basically an electronic platform where receivables of MSMEs drawn against buyers, including large corporates, public sector undertakings, and government departments, are financed through multiple financiers at competitive rates through an auction mechanism. So this fund, which is the Swavalamban Crisis Responsive Fund, is an open-ended fund, and the target is to onboard 10,000 MSMEs during the period. Usually an MSME has to pay a fee of Rs. 5,000 to Rs. 10,000 for getting registered on TREDS platform, which now SIDBI is doing free of cost. So the important questions from this news would be, which of the following has set up Swavalamban Crisis Responsive Fund? The Swavalamban Crisis Response Fund is set up for which of the following, that is MSMEs or women entrepreneurs or students or probably businesses. So you have to choose MSMEs. Expand SIDBI, expand TREDS, expand MSMEs. Also, what is the normal time duration under which, for which this scheme would be valid? So that's September 2020. Where are the headquarters of SIDBI situated? The next news is ICICI Bank has become the second official UPI partner of PhonePe. So I have a small question for you. In the comment section, you will write down what is the full form of UPI. It is a very common term which we are using in our day-to-day life these days. It is a very, very important component of the digital banking that has become a part and parcel of our life. So I want you to write down the full form of UPI. So Flipkart-owned PhonePe has announced that ICICI Bank is their new partner bank for creating and using UPI IDs for online payments. So PhonePe has almost 200 million registered users, and giving the option to use multiple UPI IDs would ensure that they can still make transaction if any one of bank's handle is temporarily out of service. Now, before ICICI Bank, it was Yes Bank, which was the partner for PhonePe, but because of the moratorium that was placed on Yes Bank by RBI, NPCI, which is the National Payments Corporation of India, had blocked the UPI handles of Yes Bank, and the PhonePe users had to struggle to make UPI-based transactions. But now with ICICI Bank coming in as the second official partner, so this problem would be solved. ICICI Bank is also the UPI partner for Google Pay, Make My Trip, Me Pay, and Truecaller. Talking about ICICI Bank, it is a bank which is headquartered in Mumbai. Girish Chandra Chaturvedi is the chairman and Sandeep Bakshi is the MD and CEO. The important questions from this news would be, which of the following banks has become the second official UPI partner of PhonePe? Or PhonePe has officially partnered with which of the following banks for UPI? Also, one question that I've already asked you is expand UPI. Some quick facts about PhonePe. It is owned by Flipkart. Its headquarters are in Bangalore, Karnataka. The founder and CEO is Sameer Nigam. The next news is Solve and Standard Chartered Bank have launched a credit card for MSMEs. Now, we've already done that MSMEs stand for micro, small and medium enterprises. So Solve, which is a B2B, B2B is a business-to-business digital platform, has announced the launch of credit card, which has been tailor-made. Tailor-made means specifically made for the MSME segment in a partnership with Standard Chartered Bank India. So this credit card would provide business owners with ready means to meet the ongoing business expenses, including the supplier payments, fuels, logistic purchase of raw material, utility payments, and other working capital outlays. So the important questions from this news could be, which of the following bank has partnered with Solve to launch MSME credit card, or which of the following segments is being catered by the recently launched credit card of Standard Chartered and Solve? Now we'll be having a look at the important reports and index. The first one is that the Global Startup Ecosystem Report 2020, which ranks Bangalore in world's top 30 startup ecosystem list. So India's startup capital, Bangalore is also known as India's startup capital. It has been ranked in world's top 30 startup ecosystem. So it is at 26th spot and is the only Indian city to feature in this list. So this list has been topped by the Silicon Valley in California. Delhi is in the runner-up category at the 36th spot, and Mumbai ranks first in the list of top 100 emerging ecosystem ranking. The list of emerging startup hubs also includes Chennai, Hyderabad, and Pune. The important questions from this news would be, which is the only Indian city to feature in the Global Startup Ecosystem Report 2020, or what is the rank of Bangalore in the Global Startup Ecosystem Report 2020? Which city has topped the world, the Global Startup Ecosystem Report 2020, and which Indian city has ranked, or which city has ranked first in the list of top 100 emerging ecosystem ranking? So this list has been released by Startup Genome. The next one is Times Higher Education has released the World Young University Ranking, which is for the relatively new generation of universities, which are 50 years old or younger. So the 2020 ranking includes 414 universities, and in 2019, it was 351. IIT Roper and IIT Indore are the two universities or IITs which have featured in this list. IIT Roper is at 62nd rank and IIT Indore is at 64th rank. So this list has been topped by Hong Kong University of Science and Technology. So this ranking judges universities on basis of five parameters of teaching, research, international outlook, and industrial output. The important questions from this news would be, which of the following have released the Young University Ranking? Which Indian university or IIT has topped in India in the Young University Ranking? Or what is the rank of IIT Roper in the Young University Ranking? Which university has topped the worldwide Young University Ranking? On how many parameters is the World Young University Ranking released? Now we'll be covering the important people in news. Malawi opposition leader Lazarus Chakwera wins historic poll rerun. So Malawi's opposition leader Lazarus Chakwera has won country's rerun presidential vote. He defeated the incumbent Peter Mutharika with 58.57% of vote. Malawi is a landlocked country in southeastern Africa, and it was formerly known as Nyasaland. The capital of Malawi is Lilongwe. So the important questions from this news would be, Lazarus Chakwera is the president of which of the following countries, or what is the name of Malawi's new president? So now we'll be covering the last section of this session, that is the important days and events. The first important day which we'll be covering would be the National Statistics Day, which is observed on 29th June in India. So this is actually the birth anniversary of Prasanth Chandra, who is considered as the father of modern statistics in India. He founded the Indian Statistical Institute. He was instrumental in formulating India's second five-year plan, which lasted from 1956 to 61. And this plan laid the blueprint for industrialization and development in India. So the theme for Statistics Day 2020 was SDG 3 and SDG 5. So SDG 3 is ensure healthy lives and promote well-being for all ages. And SDG 5 says achieve gender equality and empowerment of all women and girls. Now, what is SDG? So SDGs are the Sustainable Development Goals, which have been set up by United Nations to be achieved by 2030. So these are a list of 17 goals, which include. So this list actually includes all the important parameters, right from poverty till gender equality, clean water, sanitation, affordable and clean energy, and so on. So these were a blueprint. So in short, we can say that SDGs are a collection of 17 global designs, which are a blueprint to achieve a better and more sustainable future for all. So these were set in 2015 by the United Nations General Assembly with an aim to achieve them by 2030. So the important questions from this news would be, when is the National Statistics Day observed? National Statistics Day is the birth anniversary of who among the following? The theme of the Statistics Day 2020 focused on which of the following SDGs? Expand SDGs. So the next important day is the International Day of Parliamentarism. So this is observed on 30th June and it is a United Nations Day. It was established by the UNGA in 2018. So this day marks the establishment of Inter-Parliamentary Union, which is the global organization of parliaments. And this IPU was established in 1889. The important questions from this news could be, when is the International Day of Parliamentarism observed? In which year was the International Day of Parliamentarism established by the UNGA? When was the Inter-Parliamentary Union established? So the last news of the day is that the Culture Ministry has decided to celebrate Sankalp Parv from 28 June to 12th July. So this announcement has been made by the Union Minister of State for Culture and Tourism, Mr. Prahlad Singh Patel. So he has announced that the ministry would celebrate Sankalp Parv by planting 5 trees, which include the Bargat, Amla, Peepal, Ashok and Bel. Under this perv, all the subordinate offices, academies, affiliated and attached institution of culture ministries have been urged to plant trees in the campus or surroundings or wherever possible. So the important questions from this news would be, which of the following ministry has decided to celebrate Sankalp Parv? Under the Sankalp Parv, which of the following trees would be planted or which of the following trees would not be planted? So they could give you 5 options and you have to choose which of the following would be planted and which of the following would not be planted, depending upon the question. So with this, we have come to the end of today's session. Guys, I hope you're able to understand your current affairs and please make sure that you provide your valuable feedback and suggestions in the comment section. And if you like this video, do not forget to give a thumbs up. Thank you for listening and take care.